Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student-athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student-athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
From Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis, it's Championship Saturday, the IHSAA State Finals. Tonight, the 3A Championship game, Bellmont and Evansville Mater Dei. Chris Denary alongside Dave Nicholson, the third of four games today here in Indiana. Waldron and Jimtown have already won state championships, and Dave, we'll see who wins the 3A title.
Well, we kind of got the North against the South, Evansville against Bellmont, and they meet in the middle, and both of these teams are playing really well. I expect another good ball game just like we had this morning.
All right, we have two games tonight. The 4A game comes your way after this one. Evansville Mater Dei and Bellmont will have the starting lineups when we return on the Lassie IHSAA television network. There you see the entry to Conseco Fieldhouse tonight. The 3A state championship game, Evansville Mater Dei, the Wildcats and the Braves of Bellmont. Mater Dei comes in unranked. They're 20-6 on the year. They've won five straight games in 10 of 11. Bellmont is number seven. They've won seven straight, 8 of 9 and 11 of 13. They're 22-4. Chris Denary and Dave Nicholson, and Dave has a look at the key players for Evansville Mater Dei.
Start with number 50, Matt Halbig. 74% shooter, 16 points a game. He'll wear number 50. And number 43, Wacey Hall. And he is averaging almost 15 points a game and shooting 59% from the field. Let's look at the keys to the game for Evansville Mater Dei. Low post offense. They're going to have to score some down low tonight to be effective. Keep the starters in the game. Their bench has not been very long throughout the course of the season. And they've got to check Arnold, the 6'7", off the board.
All right, let's take a look at Evansville Mater Dei. Their head coach is John Gable, an 87 graduate. He tells us what it means to get the Wildcats to the finals.
Try to find a way to stick with our game plan, which has been to go inside first with Matt and Wacey. We need to go inside and establish some sort of inside game and be patient and somehow find a way to deal with their size and their athleticism. Of all the teams on our schedule this year, and we've had a pretty talented schedule, from top to bottom, they look like they're going to be the best, which is the way it should be. We should see them in the state championship game.
Mater Dei is representing the South. Here's the North and Bellmont.
Start with the big guard, Aaron Ritchie. He's 6'7". He averages 13 points per ball game. And inside, you go with number 33, Adam Arnold. He's a 6'6 junior, averaging 17 points a game. Keys to the game for Bellmont. They've got to have the inside-outside game. They should have that with Ritchie outside and Arnold inside. They've got to keep Arnold in the game. They cannot afford for him to get in foul trouble and be on the sideline. And they must defend the three line as Evansville Mater Dei shoots very well outside.
The head coach of the Bellmont Braves is Sean Busick. He labels his team old school.
Yeah, we did that for three reasons. One was we did it after we won the sectional. First reason we did it was to a show of unity, that we're united in a single purpose, and that is to win a state championship. Secondly, we did it, particularly with the team, is that no player is any more important than the other. We're 12 components working together to get one product, again, which is a state championship, hopefully. And then the third reason, we wanted to be old school. This is the 50th year of Milan, and you know, I'm an English teacher, and each year during the tournament I do a mini unit, and we read about the Milan players, and I'm friends with some of the players on the Milan team, and the coach, assistant coach who's still around, Clarence Kelly, is a good friend of mine. So, you know, maybe a little bit of a tribute to them, and hopefully our old school style of fundamentals and team play can carry us to a championship.
That is Sean Busick. Let's go across the way. His 19th year as the PA voice of the IHSAA State Championship. And let's join in and meet the starters for the Bellmont Braves with Scott Gray.
6 foot senior, number 22, John Caesar. At guard, a 6 foot 2 inch junior, number 32, Ryan Schmidt. At forward, a 6 foot 7 inch junior, number 13, Aaron Ritchie. At forward, a 6 foot 5 inch junior, number 44, Brian Schultz. And the center, a 6 foot 6 inch junior, number 33, Adam Arnold. Head coach of the Braves, Sean Busick.
That should get you started. Bellmont and Evansville Mater Dei coming up next on the IHSAA Television Network. Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse, the 3A state title game. Evansville Mater Dei and the Bellmont Braves. Evansville Mater Dei, the runner-up here in 3A back in 2001. They lost to Muncie South 81-78. And there you have a look at the starting lineups, Dave Nicholson. Some interesting matchups. Belmont really has some good size.
Well, you got to look at their size for Belmont, and I think Mater Dei, that's the key to them. Wacey Hall, and it is Wacey, folks, right. Not Gracie. We're not slurring his name. The 6'9 guy for Mater Dei has got to stay in the ballgame.
So Mater Dei wears the dark, the maroon on your screen. They have the basketball. They are unranked, 20-6 on the year. Belmont is ranked number 7. They're 22-4. They move the ball around. Maier out on the wing. They go inside to Wacey Hall. He draws a foul. And two free throws now for the big junior at 6'9". They beat Chittard last week to win the Seymour Semi-State 55-44. And Hall had 12 of his 20 points in the second half. He averages almost 15 points a game.
About 15, and he gets 7.5 rebounds a ball game. He's so important to this Mater Dei basketball team.
He also has 113 block shots. This is a Mater Dei program that produced Matt Keeper, who now plays in West Lafayette for Purdue. Very well known. In fact, we'll talk about this throughout the evening. These two schools are well known in the sport of wrestling in the state of Indiana, not necessarily basketball.
You're right, Chris. And, of course, Mater Dei was here in 2001 and barely lost out by 3 points to Muncie Southside.
Schultz gives the ball to Adam Arnold. Arnold to Ryan Schmidt. Schmidt, top of the key. Arnold and Schultz. That's Ritchie at 6'7", can handle the ball very well. Looks inside. Here's a three-point try, and it's short. Skimmed the front of the rim. Adam Arnold. He has only made 9 on the year, and Mater Dei has the ball. Play just 1 minute here, and the Wildcats have a 2-0 lead.
Belmont comes out in that 2-3 zone. Kind of a matchup zone, but definitely a 2-3.
Shot is short. Rebound pulled down. Munsterman up and missed it. Rebound is tipped. And Adam Arnold got it in a fast break, and it's missed by Ryan Schmidt. Coming the other way, Drew Alcorn from Mater Dei. Bounces it in the corner right. Wacey Hall has it blocked as Hall got the ball inside to Matt Halbig. And Mater Dei will have to reset the offense.
Against any zone, you got to go inside, outside. They've got good spacing. They keep a guy flashing to the high post and keep one on the low post.
Craig Maier will hit a three from the left side. A 45% three-point shooter. Yeah. 5-point lead now. Arnold has it on the top. Bellmont has yet to score. We have played over 2 minutes here in the first half. Ritchie drops it inside. That is Schultz, and he draws the foul as Wacey Hall commits it. His first, and now free throw opportunities for Bellmont.
Very nice use of the fake there by Brian Schultz. More high school players should work on that, the shot fake, and he was able to get Hall off of his feet and draw the foul.
So Brian Schultz at the line, a 75% free throw shooter. There you have a look, 6'5 junior. And his free throw's no good. Bellmont as a team, 72%. They average 59 points per game. They give up 49 points. Evansville Mater Dei scores at a 65-point clip. They give up 57 points per game. Schultz puts Bellmont on the board, a 5-1 lead for Mater Dei.
Here comes a 2-2-1 full-court press. Should be a trap there at the 10-second line.
Musterman has the ball. Maier down low, Wacey Hall, nice shot fake and scores.
You can see he has great vertical without much of a running start. He just goes up on the standstill.
7-1. The Wildcats have the lead. Ryan Schmidt. Now to Schultz. Schmidt has it back in the corner. Man-to-man defense by Mater Dei. In the lane, there's a shot that hits the top of the backboard of the shot clock. It's missed by John Zeezer at Evansville. Mater Dei will have the ball. Let's take a look at how these teams got here. Mater Dei with that 6-point lead. There you have a look at Mater Dei coming from the south, winning the Boonville sectional, the Washington regional, and beat Chatard last week in the Seymour semi-state. Bellmont coming from the north out of the Fort Wayne area. They won at New Haven. The Northwood Regional beat Fort Wayne Elmhurst 58-57 in overtime. That's James Hardy's school. And then won the Lafayette Jeff semi-state. Wildcats lead it 7-1. Slow start for Bellmont. Ritchie at the free throw line. Leans in, and they call him for a traveling violation.
I do like what Bellmont's approach is. They're not panicking coming, throwing the ball up quickly, even though they trail 7-1. They worked it, got a pretty good move there by Ritchie, and he got caught dragging his foot. And Coach Music is over there saying, what's that? There is a good looking coach on the screen.
Minsterman will leave, and in the lineup now is Zach Zirkelbach. He's a 6'2 senior. Minsterman is a 6'1 sophomore. Zirkelbach averaging 5.5 points off the bench. Free throw line is Maier. Zirkelbach and a three from the right side. Short. Zeezer, the lone senior starter for Bellmont. He plays with four juniors. And Adam Arnold, in transition, hits the three.
That is likely to get Bellmont going right there.
3-point lead for Mater Dei. First field goal tonight for Bellmont. Maier will shoot it. He rims it out. Rebound Wacey Hall in the lane, right to the basket. Offensive foul.
Lord his shoulder.
So Wacey Hall commits the foul quickly. That will be his second. So the 6'9 junior will have to go to the bench. We'll take a break. 3:42 to play in the quarter. Wildcats have a 3-point lead. Some of the fans there have made their way from Evansville supporting Mater Dei here. Wildcats, they have the lead on the Methodist Sports Medicine Center scoreboard, 7-4. Crowd of over 14,000 this afternoon for the game. Should have another great crowd here tonight.
That fan with the 42, that's Dennis Casey's best buddy. I'm pretty sure they came in the same car.
Full court pressure now by Mater Dei. Ritchie gets the ball
back and forth
across the line. He was very nearly, you're right, he was right in front of us. Looked like he went over and back. And Zeezer has the ball, a two-year starter, four-year member of the varsity, the lone senior in the starting lineup, as Sean Busick has four junior starters. Schmidt to the baseline, wraps it around, and that's the third foul on Wacey Hall.
You know, I was just thinking, why is Hall still out there? And he just picked up his third one.
Well,
you would think he's played with fouls. You're going to see it here.
Well, officially now, they have him for two. So apparently that last foul was his first. I I think Dave and I thought he had had two, but that's his second now, so at least
okay.
He does now, though, have to go to the bench. We thought he would be there. And now John Gable has to send him to the bench, and the free throw was good by Adam Arnold.
Nice take there by Adam Arnold, and he went right at Hall. I take back what I said. I thought that was his third foul, as you said. It made sense in there with one, but it didn't make any sense with him out there with two, at least until he gathers his thoughts a little bit. He may come back with him in the first half. I don't know if they've got a replacement for Wacey Hall.
7-6. Mater Dei has the lead. The ball is kicked out of bounds. 3:02 to play. There you see the clock. And Minsterman is back in the lineup now for Evansville Mater Dei. He averages almost 9 points a game. His father, Terry, led the city in scoring of Evansville back in 1973. His mother, Mary Ellen, in 1978, was the leading scorer and rebounder at Mater Dei. So a great heritage there for the young sophomore. And he's back on the floor after going to the bench. Zirkelbach will fire a three. And Ritchie gets the rebound on the floor. Bellmont looks for its first lead. They have not led in the game. Ritchie has the ball. Bounces for Ryan Schmidt. Zeezer is the point guard. He runs things for Bellmont.
The call on the sideline might be a good idea to get it to Arnold right there down the low post.
Flips it up toward the basket, and Adam Arnold has two more. He has 7 first half points, and the first lead for the Bellmont Braves is 8-7.
Well, he got the shot at the low post. That wasn't exactly what I was talking about. I thought he might park down there and he might throw it to him. Now, I don't know anyone that they may have, but I'm not sure they have anyone to guard him right now on the field.
7-0 run, all behind Adam Arnold. 2 minutes to play here in quarter number one at Conseco Fieldhouse. A drive to the baseline for Mater Dei, working against this zone. Splitting the lane is Alcorn, and his jumper is good. Drew Alcorn, 4.5 points a game. He's on the board, and Mater Dei has regained a 1-point lead. Nice pass.
That's what I was talking about. Getting Arnold down low. He can pin really well. He seals off his defender and does a great job down there. And of course, Hall was the one that Evansville Mater Dei was going to depend on to defend him, and he picked up the two quick personals on the sideline.
And Arnold makes a nice defensive play to knock that ball out of bounds. 90 seconds to play here in the first quarter. Ryan Mendez in the lineup now. There you saw him, number 24 in the white uniform for Bellmont. Also back now, Craig Maier for Evansville Mater Dei.
Mendez gives Bellmont another outside shooter as he shot 41% on the year from the three line. They may have to knock some of those down.
Nice spin move. Halbig couldn't get it. Now we have a personal foul called against Mater Dei. So Bellmont will have the ball. Pushing foul. There you have a look at Adam Arnold and sixth year head coach Sean Busick.
Here comes a replay, and you see the good take to the basket. And the rebound comes off, and I believe they got Arnold.
Yeah.
Who was it, please?
Corey Gable is called for the foul. So Arnold had nice position, and Bellmont has the ball looking to build on the lead. Aaron Ritchie misses. His father, Adrian, is the principal at Bellmont and played his high school basketball at Anderson Highland.
Remember him well. He was a great player there for Anderson Highland. You mentioned Coach Busick a minute ago. He had a coaching experience at Lebanon High School, and two of his mentors you know quite well, Big Ed Schilling and, of course, the legendary Jim Rosenstiel.
Arnold misses, and Gable, the rebound, comes out of there. And with 32 seconds to play in the quarter, Mater Dei trying to regain the lead with a long three. It's good. Minsterman hits the three, his 34th of the year. He's a 44% three-point shooter. And it's a 12-10 lead for Mater Dei.
Got 8 seconds, so they'll go to the basket with about 4 seconds.
And it's stolen. Drew Alcorn near the buzzer, lays it in, and that's the way the quarter will end. 5 consecutive points for the Wildcats of Evansville Mater Dei. First of three by Minsterman, then Alcorn a steal and a layup. It's a 4-point Mater Dei lead on the Lassie IHSAA television network. Mater Dei with the late first quarter run has a four-point lead on the Methodist Sports Medicine scoreboard as we head to the second 8 minutes here at Conseco Fieldhouse. And one of the keys for Bellmont that gave them the lead, the play of Adam Arnold. He has 9 of their 10 points, and right now pretty balanced for Mater Dei.
Pretty balanced, and the only thing that Mater Dei's got working against them, remember, Gracie Hall went out with his second foul with about 3 minutes and 19 seconds left there in the first quarter.
Bellmont has the ball. They trail. Nice move. Hall is back on the lineup. He was defending Brian Schultz in a rebound basket. And again, it is Adam Arnold.
You notice when they went at Hall, though, he played soft. He backed off. He can't afford to pick up the third foul. And I think, without question, Bellmont will pick up on that and keep attacking inside.
Three-point goal, Andy Reddington. 31 threes coming in, 40% off the bench. It's a very good three-point shooting team at 40% on the year. And the Wildcats have a five-point lead. Just underway in the second quarter. This is the 3A state title game. Chris Denary, Dave Nicholson. Later you'll hear from the third member of our team, Greg Wallen. All the coverage tonight for you of all the state finals games. Two winners earlier today, Waldron and Jimtown in Class A and 2A. We'll see who wins the 3A title game here, and Hall picks up the loose ball. Craig Maier hit two free throws to win the regional against Vincennes a couple of weeks ago. He's number 11. Minsterman left side to Reddington. He just hit a three.
Nice ball movement.
Boy, same spot and location, and the same outcome for Andy Reddington.
Well, once you hit one, your confidence soars, and you get it again, you feel pretty good about yourself.
Zeezer couldn't get it to fall, but he gets the rebound, and then Reddington commits the foul. It will be a foul. Biggest lead of the game right now by either team, and for Mater Dei, they lead by 8. Wildcats will go to the bench, and Matt Halbig comes back in. There you see him there starting forward. 16.5 points and 8 rebounds. He had 17 in the win against Indianapolis Chittard last week. In the lane, the roll from Brian Schultz.
It's very clear that they're going to attack Wacey Hall. They're taking the ball directly inside, trying to get him to commit that third person.
And now Hall attacks. Nice fake by Halbig. Had the shot blocked, and he'll shoot free throws. Personal foul is on Adam Arnold. That will be his first. It will be the second against Bellmont. Let's take another look.
Here's your replay. Nice pass from Hall down to Halbig. And a very good job of protecting the ball, going up and drawing the foul.
Matt Halbig is a very good left-handed pitcher on the baseball field for Evansville Mater Dei, and he's a 73% free throw shooter. As a team, Mater Dei at 72%. We saw Lee Schoolfield in the lineup for the first time for Mater Dei. Both free throws good by Halbig.
One thing in Mater Dei's favor, Chris, is they do have a deeper bench and have used it more throughout the year than has Bellmont. And they're showing that here early in the first half.
Zeezer. Schultz misses. And Halbig there to clear the rebound. Play 2 minutes here in the second quarter. Pass goes inside. Halbig draws the foul. Brian Schultz got him on the arm. And Matt Halbig will go right back to the free throw line where he is 2 of 2 on the evening.
You see a nice post up here by Halbig. See, drop step, hesitates. Same as a fake, froze the defender, went up and drew the contact.
That one he left short. Mater Dei has won 5 straight, of course, so all in postseason play and 10 of the last 11. There you see Ryan Blythe in the lineup. He replaces Ryan Mendez. Blythe is a 6'1 senior for Bellmont. Located southeast of Fort Wayne, they represent the northern semi-state. And there you see the fans of Evansville Mater Dei as they have a 9-point lead. Biggest lead of the game now for the team out of the Pocket City. Belmont's in the white. They go inside. Schultz. Outside left, Caesar. His runner in the lane, short around the rim, and Halbig has the rebound. 14-4 run right now by the Wildcats. They'll look to add and take it to double figures if they can. School field, they go right inside to Halbig with a left hand. He missed it, tried for his own rebound. Wacey Hall is there, counted, and a foul. Wacey Hall on the glass, put it up and in. He has a chance now. Day for a three-point play.
Good inside play. They went inside, outside, go back inside, and there you see the move by Halbig, and there is Hall just pulling it down with two hands, taking it up, protecting the ball during the foul. Chance for three, as you said. They think he's a Division I player right there, Wacey Hall.
6 points, two rebounds, and two fouls here early in this game. We talked earlier, 113 block shots in 26 games this year. He's a 60% field goal shooter, a 70% free throw shooter. And that time he skims it off the front edge of the rim. Biggest lead of the game for Mater Dei. They lead by 11. Minsterman back on the floor for Mater Dei. Out there defending Ryan White.
Mater Dei showing real solid man-to-man defense. Helping out well, rotating well, doubling inside.
Baker gives the ball to Aaron Ritchie. Leans in. There's a block from Hall. Bellmont will reset in the half-court offense. Wearing the high socks, like we like to wear back in the 70s, a steal. Reddington will lay it in. Andy Reddington off the bench has scored 8 points. And that forces Sean Busick to call a timeout. We'll take a break. A big run for Mater Dei. They have a 13-point second quarter lead on the Lassie IHSAA television network. Evansville Mater Dei has opened up a 13-point second quarter lead on runs right now working, a 7-0 run, 13-2, and overall 18-4 after Bellmont had taken a 10-9 lead. And right now Adam Arnold has played well for Bellmont, but the rest of the team not getting the job done.
You're right, Arnold 4-6 shooting, the rest of the team only 1-9. Teammates got to pick it up a little bit. Mater Dei, on the other hand, great balance. They have six players with at least 3 points already. There's your replay, and that's a blocking call, a good call. Defender not quite ready to establish position.
Aaron Ritchie gets the ball into Adam Arnold. Full court pressure here by Mater Dei. Safely across the timeline in the front court, and a long three. It's missed by Ryan Schmidt. Offensive rebound. Arnold can't get it. He's there for the rebound again, but Wacey Hall gets it. Ahead to Halbig now, and Mater Dei had numbers, but they'll have to hold it up. Minsterman was looking for the ball. Now they dump the ball inside to Hall, gets right there and lays it in.
Showed really good balance and coordination on that move. Hung in the air, had good body control.
Well, across the way, the Bellmont fans are very quiet now as a big run by Mater Dei as they have opened up a 15-point lead.
We saw this happen earlier in the day, though, in the Brownstown game, and they were able to work back into it. So, a lot of time left.
Jason Miller missed a three from the left wing. This is a Bellmont team that many thought was a year away with four juniors in the starting lineup, but Sean Busick got them here to Indianapolis, and now a foul. Miller fouling Andy Reddington, who has been very critical off the bench. Reddington has already come in there. You see him, a 6 foot junior, has already scored 8 points and hit back-to-back threes that really jump-started this run.
With that foul, he's going to get a rest, but you're right, he's got 8 big points in the second quarter, and I think you're right on Bellmont. The Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame just selected them to play in the Hall of Fame Classic next year, so they think they're going to have a pretty good basketball team next year as well.
Meyer, top of the key for three. That one spins out. Ritchie, the rebound. It's a good field next year at Newcastle. Bellmont will play Muncie Central. And then two very good senior big men next year, Carmel and Washington. It will be Josh McRoberts of Carmel and Luke Zeller of Washington. Well, those will be four good teams and a lot of good games next year.
Yeah, I think everybody would want to see that basketball game when the two big boys match up and with Robertson.
Minsterman went to the basket, is fouled. And the call is against Bellmont. I don't think it will be a shooting foul. Adam Arnold wasn't sure he liked that call. Well, he did. Well, there's see the replay hit him right across the face.
He fouled him without question. Not much complaint.
Videotape really never lies, does it, Dave?
Sometimes as a broadcaster or as a player, you wish they didn't have
because
most of the time the officials get it right.
That's right.
Halbig on the post, right to the basket, looped it in with a left hand.
Up and under, nice move.
31-14, Mater Dei was here 3 years ago, couldn't get it done. They're trying to get it done here tonight, right now with 2:40 to play.
Stepped on the in line, that goes right back to Mater Dei again, a chance to build on this big lead.
And with 2:40 to play in the second quarter, and there you see John Gable, his uncle, the longtime football and wrestling coach at Mater Dei. You think about Mater Dei, they've won 9 of the past 10 titles in wrestling and have won numerous football championships. They're trying to get it done in basketball.
Nice pass.
Ball spins. Call for the walking violation.
A little contact there with Jason Miller from Bellmont, but they say Hall scooted his foot.
And now Wacey Hall will leave, and he'll go to the bench with 8 first half points and 2 personal fouls with 2:17 to play, so Mater Dei gets a lot smaller.
A nice coaching move there by John Gable. He's protecting Hall with 2 fouls, but he has a 17-point lead, so he can have that luxury of saving him for the second half.
Zirkelbach has called for the foul. Bellmont has gone cold. But free throws now for Bellmont, so the clock stops. And Zeezer at the free throw line, where he's a 71% free throw shooter, averaging 7 points, 3 rebounds, and almost 6 assists per game. Bellmont is shooting only 5 of 19 from the field at 26%. Counter that with Mater Dei, 11 of 22. And they've also hit 4 threes.
Well, we always talk about get that lead down to 10 or less by halftime if you're behind. And they've got a shot to do that. They've got to have a couple of stops on defense, go up and get the ball, get a basket.
Nice backdoor play. Off the back of the iron, missed by Zirkelbach. Arnold cleared it for Bellmont. Arnold at the top of the key. He's hit a 3 there earlier. He misses that one. Nice position on the rebound. Drew Alcorn was there. And a personal foul against Bellmont.
You got this Ryan Schmidt that got that number 32. I have him on for his first one. He was trying to crash, get an offensive board, and Alcorn did a nice job of checking him off.
So Drew Alcorn goes to the free throw line, where a week ago in the semi-state championship win against Chittard, he had 20 points. Hit 6 of 15 from the field, but most importantly, hit 8 of 9 free throws. And he has 4 points here tonight. Richie grabs the rebound for Bellmont. 90 seconds to play in the second quarter. Ball just sort of slipped right out of the hands of Ryan Schmidt.
Ryan kind of looked down and said, what happened? But that's exactly right. The ball just flew out of his hands. No contact.
That's a turnover. The ball comes flying over our way. Knocked out of bounds, and Mater Dei will have the ball back.
Official gave me credit for an assist. I think he had Tim and I mixed up there. Our stat man, Denver, did a nice job saving that ball.
15-point lead for Mater Dei as we wind down the final seconds. Final minute here of the second quarter.
Really crisp passing by Mater Dei in this half, Chris. They've just been moving the ball sharply, picking their spots, and getting it pretty much where they want it.
Let's see if Mater Dei and Meyer will work for the final shot of the half, but Halbert goes right to the basket and lays it in. 33-16. Bellmont trails by 17. inside a minute here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Zeezer in the corner now to Schmidt. Lobs it down low. Arnold will turn. Halbig there to defend. Three maroon jerseys under the basket. Easily grab the rebound. And now the Wildcats will play for the final shot.
I would think so. 32nd. You've got the nice 17-point lead.
That's Craig Maier out there dribbling at the center circle. Minsterman now with the ball. John Gable has to feel very good with what his team has done. Mike Gable, his uncle, the longtime football and wrestling coach. 4 seconds to play. Minsterman. Will they get a shot off? Halbig. They aren't going to get the shot off. They used too much time off the clock. That may be the only thing that went wrong for Evansville Mater Dei in half number one. A big first half lead for the Wildcats. They have a 17-point lead. Mater Dei 33 and Bellmont 16. And standing by with the coach who's in the lead, John Gable, with our Craig Wallen. Craig?
Thank you very much, Chris. And coach, a very good first half. I thought you had great balance, great inside-out game. And even with Hall out, you were able to make up some ground.
You know, we've been, that was one of our game, parts of our game plan was to go inside, and we've had some success at it, and we've been able to get to the foul line a little bit. You know, part of the thing, too, is back here on defense is they're missing some shots that are open, too. So that's a big help for us, too.
And your bench played well as well.
Yeah, we've had good bench support all year. We play 9-10 guys, and they all come in and contribute where they can.
All right, coach, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, guys, back to you.
All right, thanks, Craig. Great bench contributions. Andy Reddington and Wacey Hall have 8. Matt Halbig has 7. It's been all Wildcats. They have a 17-point halftime lead. Chris Denary, Dave Nicholson, Craig Wallen, our entire telecast team here courtside at Conseco Fieldhouse, the 3A state championship game. Evansville Mater Dei scored the last 5 points of the first quarter, and they go on to take a 17-point halftime lead, 33-16. They're on a 24-6 run as we go to the halftime break. Our Watson's trivia question during our 3A state championship game. What school was the last Fort Wayne area school to win a boys' state title? Last Fort Wayne area school to win a boys' state title, our Watson's trivia quiz. The answer, back in 2001, Harding won a state championship. The Associated Builders and Contractors of Indiana salutes one of their Evansville members, Hoppy & Sons Construction. Fred Hoppy, a state wrestling champ for Mater Dei in 1964. Hoppy & Sons have won Contractor Excellence State Championships for their construction work in the Metzger Zoo Project and the BASI facility in Evansville. There you see Bobby Plump and Ray Crapp, many of the members of the Milan State Championship team being honored here at the half. At the half, a big lead for Evansville Mater Dei over the Bellmont Braves. Mary and Dave Nicholson, a standing ovation here at the half. Members of our color guard have just returned from being over in Iraq for the Iraqi Freedom Group. They represent many of our nation's heroes that are over battling for the freedom of the United States. And great to see those young men here today.
Of all the winners here today, oh, that's the real
absolutely
winners right there,
right,
Chris.
This is just a game. They have battled for our country, and wonderful things that they have done, and they receive the recognition here courtside. Let's take a look at our halftime stats, our 3A state final game. Mater Dei with a big lead, and David comes down to shooting the ball.
There's one stat, you hit it on the nose, the field goal percentage. Check it out. Bellmont 24%, Mater Dei 50%. Everything else relatively even, but you've got to make baskets. And to this point, Bellmont just has not been able to do that, Chris.
Adam Arnold has 11 of the 16 points for Bellmont. He is 4 of 9 from the field. The rest of the team is only 1 of 12.
Well, I know the teammates can play better than that. They know they can play better than that. And you can bet that Sean Busick, the coach, is down there telling them they can play better than that. They're young. They may come out and play a great second half.
All right.
Get the composure back and go to work.
Sean Busick is the head coach of the Bellmont Braves, and he is standing by with Craig Wallen. Craig?
Thank you, Chris. Adam Arnold had a pretty good first half, coach, but the rest of the team had some looks but couldn't get it to drop.
Well, it's a tough venue. Hopefully that first half will help us out a little bit. Now we get the eyes for the bucket, block out everything but the rim. But best thing for us right now is we've got to really play defense. I don't think we defended very well the first half. Hopefully what we can do here is establish some defensive intensity and some defensive stops, quit giving them second shots, and contest their shooters. They're a very good shooting team.
They are. Thank you, Coach, and best luck in the second half.
Thank you very much.
Back to you guys.
All right, this is a Bellmont team that beat number one Concordia in a sectional semifinal. Coming out of the north, they had to do a good job this year to beat Concordia, Leo, and Elmhurst. And let's take a look at our first half highlights as Evansville Mater Dei, Dave, has a 17-point first half lead.
Nice three from the corner.
Andy Reddington hit that. Reddington, he hit two off the bench.
Hit two of them and had 8 points there in the second quarter.
That was another three-point shot. That was Minsterman, the sophomore, 6-1 for Mater Dei.
Nice off the dribble move there by Alcorn. Body balance, as you know, you've got to take that 1-2 shot when you're shooting it. He did it very well, got his feet under him.
That was the one guy that did things for Bellmont in the first half, Adam Arnold. He took the ball to the basket, hit an early three. He has been the highlight here for Bellmont.
Sure has. He's got 11 of their 16 points, according to my unofficial chart. And the good thing is he only has one personal foul if you're a Bellmont fan, so he can play wide open the second half.
You recognize that guy?
That's the guy
Jimmy
from
Chitwood.
Hoosiers.
That's right.
Jimmy Chitwood.
That's not his real name. I always forget what his real. I just think he's Jimmy.
He lives out by Tri-West High School.
Jimmy Chitwood. They honored the members of the Milan team as well as some of the people that were in the movie Hoosiers back in the late 80s.
One of the members of that Milan team I worked with for many years at Noblesville High School, and Roland Cutter, the counselor.
And his son went into coaching. Rob went to Butler University, a very successful football coach at Hamilton Southeastern.
That's the only mistake I tell him he's ever made. I talked to him this
week. For you.
He went to into football. Rob played on our undefeated 1984 team and was a great, great person and a very, very good basketball player for us. Of course, he did quarterback at Butler. And,
yes.
And he said wherever the opportunity comes when he got out of college, I'm going to go that way. He loved both sports. And he didn't make a mistake because he has done a wonderful job there at Southeast.
Mater Dei has the ball to start the third quarter. They're in the dark uniforms, the maroon, and Craig Maier will start with a three-point shot. Pretty good way to start the quarter when you come in up 17.
If you're Coach Music, that's the last thing you want to see. Now you're down 20, and it doesn't change your game plan. It just makes it a little tougher. And I think the game plan is now, if you're Bellmont, you've got to come up and shoot the ball a little quicker. You're down 20. Can't make too many passes. Attack the basket. Try to put the pressure back on Evansville Mater Dei.
Get the ball inside. Hall is there and somehow scores the basketball. Wacey Hall in double figures. He has 10 and the lead is 22 for Mater Dei.
We give Wacey Hall a lot of credit. He played a long time with two personal fouls in that first half, and he's now got three left, so he can go full speed here in the second half.
Arnold in the lane with a nice post move, counting the foul, the third on Wacey Hall.
I should never say that when I'm saying that. He's actually getting his third one. I think they'll leave him in a little bit. We're going to see a replay on this. Belmont does a good job of going inside with Arnold. Backs him down, and Hall's just going to have to be a little bit careful. Go straight up on that. Try to influence the shot, but maybe not try to swat it.
And Arnold now has 14 points. He has 14 of their 19 in the game. 19-point lead for Mater Dei, early stages of the third quarter.
Well, if I'm Mater Dei, while Hall's in there with three, I'd get him the ball a few times and make use of his offensive skills because you know sooner or later that Coach Gable's going to set him down a little bit and give him a break.
Shot is missed by Brian Schultz. Ball knocked out of bounds, and Bellmont will retain possession. The good thing about Bellmont is you heard Sean Busick in the first half talk about we want to be old school. We want to look back to the old. I can tell my three sons that they have brought the socks back that I wore 25 years ago. I didn't think they existed anymore.
I'll tell you what, Chris, you put green stripes on those, and that's Chris Canary going up and down the floor, knocking in those long-range jump shots. Gave me nightmares.
Minsterman has the ball in the corner. Mater Dei playing with that big lead. And they still attack. You don't want to take too much time off the clock. Maier right to the basket and gets the roll.
Maier with the basket. Maier.
8 points for Maier. Arnold with a left hand. Nice dump off pass, and Brian Schultz lays it in.
Good interior passing, as you said, to find your teammates when you're on the way up and you get double teamed.
Bellmont has to find a way to get some stops. They cannot trade baskets. They have dug themselves too big a hole.
Well, I thought Coach Busick was dead on. He said just what you just repeated. We've got to get a stand defensive going before we're going to cut this lead. You're not going to outscore them by all those points. You've got to get stops. And they just haven't done it to this point.
Traveling violation. There you see Corey Gable. He's in the lineup now for Mater Dei. He played briefly in the first half and did not score. Bellmont looks inside again. Arnold draws a double team. He can step and shoot that shot. Mater Dei saves the ball. That was outgoing. He was tiptoeing there along the end line. And Mater Dei, as we approach 5 minutes to play. Here in the third quarter, 3A state title game. Mater Dei was here in 2001, the runner-up to Muncie South. Minsterman will fire a three and hit it.
He got one of those in the first half. And he shoots 44% on the season from out there, so that's not an unusual shot for him.
Second time that Mater Dei has had a 22-point lead. They also led 38-16.
What this has enabled Coach John Gable to do is to keep Hall on the bench, protecting him with those three personals. He probably won't come back in this quarter if they can maintain that 20-point lead.
Aaron Ritchie out behind the arc, looks inside. Arnold catches, doesn't get it. Right back up, left it short. Nice rebound, third effort, Brian Schultz.
Arnold and Schultz, they work pretty well together in there. Get one of them on one side of the basket and one on the other side. Thought he might have studied step and traveled, though.
Maier looks to Minsterman. Good perimeter game working for Mater Dei. They've hit 6 of 11 from behind the arc here in the game. Maier, free throw line. Alcorn will shoot a 17-footer and hit it.
Very, very nice. Off the dribble move again. We've seen young men do that today. If you're a young player out there, you've got to develop that shot fake, dribble, jump shot.
They have hit 5 of their first 6 field goals here in the third quarter, shooting 57%. Arnold scores in a foul. 3-point play opportunity for Bellmont as Matt Halbig committed the foul. So Adam Arnold will go to the free throw line. He has 5 second half points. He has 16 in the game. A nice pass by Brian Schultz. He threw it where only Arnold could catch it.
And Arnold's able to go to work a little bit down there again with Wacey Hall on the bench. Not quite as much interference for him.
And Arnold's free throw is good. It was 17 at the half. It's 19 here in the third quarter. Evansville Mater Dei leads the 3A state title game. Evansville Mater Dei has a 19-point lead in the third quarter on the Methodist Sports Medicine Center scoreboard. When you're injured in sports, at work, or at play, trust Indiana's most experienced sports medicine team. A Clarion Health partner taking care of the Colts, 10 colleges, more than 25 Central Indiana high schools, and is the official sports medicine provider of the IHSAA and tonight's state championship basketball game. 4 Indianapolis area locations. Call 1-800-SPORTS-MED. Visit the web at methodistsports.com. Sports Work Life, Methodist Sports Medicine Center, keeping you in the game. Methodist Sports Medicine physicians and trainers on the sidelines tonight. There's a 3 try from Minsterman. It's saved by Schultz, and then the ball will go out of bounds, and it will stay with Mater Dei.
Yep, it'll stay right there. Good scramble for the rebound. About 6 different players touched that ball, and it went off of Bellmont.
Halbig catches. He's a left-hander.
Here's what I like about Mater Dei.
Illegal screen they're called.
Not a little illegal screen is what I like. They had moved the ball. That was about 8 or 10 passes in that first possession. And again, with Hall on the bench, I think that's a smart thing to do. They lead by 19 points.
Andy Reddington is called for that foul. That's his second. Ryan Mendez is on the floor. He's at the point, a 5'9 senior for Bellmont, averaging 2 points and a rebound a game. Now Mater Dei shows zone. Little 1-2-2 zone here.
You got it. The 1-2-2 should be open in the middle if they pop one to the high post right here.
There's Arnold at the free throw line. He's in the center of that zone. Aaron Ritchie now, who averages 13 points a game, has not scored. He's only taken two shots. Ritchie out on the perimeter. They whip it around the perimeter, and there's Arnold. Free throw line jumper. It's good.
That's the soft spot in the 1-2-2. Free throw line area's got to be open. If they come up and defend it, you should be able to go high-low, get it down to low post.
Eight in the quarter for Adam Arnold, the third quarter. Here in the second half, he has 19 points in the game. Mater Dei has the ball, playing with a 17-point lead. And that's where the lead was at the half, at 33-16. So three-point shot missed. He made two of those in the first half. Reddington, he missed it there. And then Bellmont nearly threw it away. Final 2 minutes of the third quarter here at Conseco Fieldhouse. A quarter away from crowning our third state titleist of the day. Ball knocked out of bounds. The Associated Builders and Contractors of Indiana salutes one of their Evansville members, Hoppy & Sons Construction. Fred Hoppy, a state wrestling champ for Mater Dei in 1964. Hoppy & Sons have won Contractor Excellence State Championships for their construction work in the Mester Zoo Project and the BASI facility in Evansville.
During that read, Aaron Ritchie missed a three-pointer in the right corner. There's a young man just hasn't been able to get going. He averages 13 points a ball game. I have him for 0 points here tonight.
Ball goes inside, kept alive by Halbig, but it's tracked down by Brian Schultz. Here comes Bellmont, crowd on its feet across the way, trying to get the Braves energized in an air ball on the baseline, and everybody just sits down.
The Braves have had opportunities to get right back in this ball game, but the same thing as the first half. Their shooting percentage is not allowing them to do that.
Halbig inside, draws a double team, looks, dumps it out the corner to Reddington. And Maier sets the ball with Zach Zirkelbach. He played briefly in the first half. Reddington inside Halbig at the elbow. And Maier will work to the free throw line. Nice pass on the bounce. And Halbig, too strong, got his own rebound, but a foul. And a foul over the top will be called on Bellmont with 44 and 2/10 seconds to play, and the foul is on Aaron Ritchie.
Well, Bellmont's got to do a little better job of checking off several times, and again, just now, it was the second attempt that hurt them. This time, Mater Dei drew the foul, but they've had several putback backs, and Bellmont's just got to check off a little better, and Coach Music just made it a change, and probably for that reason.
Gable inbounds the ball to Maier. Maier, left hand. Cut off there by Ryan Blight. Reddington with Halbig.
You know, Mater Dei has not been able to score in the last three or four possessions.
Right by Maier, didn't get it to fall, but free throws now. I was a little surprised. I thought they might work for the final shot of the quarter, but Maier saw an alley and went right to the basket.
I did too with the 17-point lead. You remember this morning, Waldron had that nice lead, and they tried to slow down and get out of their pace they'd been in, and it really didn't work for them. And I was thinking that might happen to Mater Dei. The difference is Bellmont has not been able to capitalize at the other end on the possessions they've gotten.
76% free throw shooter Maier. Yeah, hit two big free throws in the regional to beat Vincennes this year, and he's won three games on the year with either a last-second field goal or free throw.
And that noise you hear to the east, that's a celebration going on in Walden right now. I hear the roar once in a while.
I'll tell you, we were in the media room between games, and one of the local television stations was showing the pep rally. It was wall-to-wall at the Waldron Gym.
Well, now there's thousands of people out there to say they live in Waldron. There's only 500 people live there, so that's the way it goes when you win. Everybody jumps on that bandwagon, and that's going to last for a long, long time out there.
19-point lead for Mater Dei. Bellmont will work for the final shot of the third quarter. 8 seconds to play. Ryan Blythe out front. Goes to the baseline and is fouled. Will not be a shooting foul. And now Bellmont will have 3 and 6/10 seconds to try to make something happen.
That foul is on Andy Reddington.
That's his third, team foul number four. They lob it inside. Arnold lost the ball, picked up. Halbig will throw it length of the floor and hits the side of the backboard. And three quarters are in the books. Mater Dei had a 17-point halftime lead. They have increased it by two. Wildcats 47, Braves 28. Fourth quarter to come here at Conseco Fieldhouse. That's the look outside of Conseco Fieldhouse here in Indianapolis. So the warm temperatures mean spring is on the way. Final day and night of high school basketball here in this great state of Indiana. Chris Denary, Dave Nicholson, and Craig Wallman, happy to be courtside with you. This is the 3A state title game, and right now it's been all Evansville Mater Dei. They have a 19-point lead. Let's see what Bellmont can do, Dave, here in the fourth quarter.
To verify that, Chris, Evansville Mater Dei, all of their players are approaching their average. The only player to exceed the average they've had on the season for Bellmont has been Arnold. He's carried all the way with 19 points. The other players, Schultz has stepped up and had a good game with 7. He averages 9, but got to have some help.
Richie missed that three-point shot. Now the other way, the foul on Bellmont. And again, we hate to pound in on it, but Adam Arnold is 7 of 15 from the field. The rest of the team is 3 of 20, and that has just been a problem. They have looked, Belmont's looked a little bit more like they have been affected by the environment here. Again, this is a young team, one senior starter and four juniors, and I think you heard Sean Busick at the half with Craig Wallen. He felt maybe that the environment had really created not making the shots.
I think that's true, but when you look at Evansville Mater Dei, pretty young as well.
Yeah.
They have one senior in Halbig and Alcorn, but they have a sophomore and a couple of juniors in their lineup, so you're probably right. But Evansville had been here before. Maybe they draw a little bit from that tradition.
Wacey Hall, he's on the board here in the quarter. He's in double figures. He has 12, and the lead is 21 for Evansville Mater Dei.
Mater Dei stays in that zone. They kind of flatten it out, almost a 3-2 zone now, protecting that middle a little more.
They can stay back in that zone. Hall has three personal fouls. Zeezer's shot is short, and it's off the arm of Wacey Hall.
Well, I think, and of course, John Gable thinks the same thing, apparently. I would pack that zone in because Bellmont just is not shooting the ball well until they prove they can hit it. Stay in that zone because you got a nice lead.
Ryan Schmidt hits a three-pointer.
Now, if Bellmont's able to get two or three more of those back-to-back, then you can bet that Mater Dei will come out of that zone.
Craig Maier. Bellmont trying to put more pressure on. They get the ball to Halbig. Halbig will stop and look. Block is the ally right now of Mater Dei. Hall gets it back out to Maier. Maier had a good third quarter with 7 points. He has 10 points in the game, and Mater Dei turns it over.
And you saw Coach John Gable say, hey, Craig Maier, we've got a nice lead. You don't have to make the impossible play. Just be patient, keep the ball moving, keep the clock running. Got 6 minutes and 10 seconds, and we'll start cutting some net.
Bellmont has the ball, member of the Northeast Hoosier Conference. Columbia City, who will play in the 4A championship game tonight, also a member of that conference. And Arnold hits.
Found that soft spot right in the middle of the zone again, and that's where they should be attacking because that's where the hole is in the 3-2 zone.
49-33 in Mater Dei, and we have a walking violation. John Gable is up off the bench. Mater Dei and the Wildcats want a timeout. It's a 30-second timeout as he tries to calm the nerves of the Mater Dei Wildcats.
Exactly right. That's a good move on his part because he still has a very nice lead of 16 points. They don't have to rush things, don't have to take any chances. Be safe with the basketball.
Methodist Sports Medicine Center, a Clarion Health partner, treats athletes and active people throughout Indiana and is the official sports medicine provider of the IHSAA and state championship events. Visit 4 Indianapolis area locations. In downtown Indianapolis, Carmel, Avon, and Greenwood, call 1-800-SPORTS-MED or visit the web at methodistsports.com. Sports work life. We keep you in the game. and the Associated Builders and Contractors of Indiana salute one of their Evansville members, Hoppy and Sons Construction. Fred Hoppy, a state wrestling champ for Mater Dei in 1964. Hoppy and Sons winning Contractor Excellence State Championships for their construction work in the Mesker Zoo Project and the BASI facility in Evansville. Proud to support the Wildcats of Mater Dei. 16-point margin is as close as Bellmont has been in this second half. And now, Richie fell down. Sean Busick is up. He thought his player was tripped, and that meant the ball had nowhere to go but out of bounds.
Well, you can't blame Coach Busick for pleading his case because Bellmont had a mini run going. A lot of people might say, you know, Coach John Gable, why is he worried about it? He's got a 16-point lead. Chris, and you and I have been around basketball way too long.
3-point shot changes everything.
With 5 minutes and a half to go, but plenty of time.
Nice move by Wacey Hall in the lane. He draws the foul.
The match of the big man, I think that was Adam Arnold that got him on the wrist.
Well, you have to believe, you look back a few years, he'll be a junior next year at Purdue, and Matt Kiefer and Wacey Hall, a big man for Mater Dei.
Pretty similar. There's a nice spin move by Hall down the middle, and you saw Arnold go up and just get him on the touch and on the wrist. If you interfere with the shot, it doesn't have to be a hard foul. The official's going to call it.
Hall has 13 points. He averages almost 15 per game. Free throw is short. Ball tipped out.
You're right. You can see some similarities there with Hall, with Kiefer. Kiefer did a lot more outside shooting when he was in high school than he has footwork to do, but he may pick that up next year.
Nice little jump hook by Brian Schultz. He now has 9 points. He and Arnold have combined for 28 of their 35 points. 50 to 35. And Minsterman has the ball. Knocked out of play by Arnold.
Here's the replay, and you're going to see Arnold just time it perfectly. Minsterman goes to the basket, uses a shot fake like he's supposed to, and it wasn't his man that got it, but here comes Arnold like a good shot blocker. It's always that second guy coming over to help. He's got the best shot at blocking.
Maier with the basketball. Drew Alcorn. Minsterman. Starting lineup on the floor right now for Mater Dei. They'll go to the bench with Andy Reddington. And there's a nice move by Hall. He knocked over Brian Schultz as he laid it in.
I think he had to step on Schultz. I think it was a good no call. Schultz was hoping that brush would get called, but I think it was a good play.
Zeezer off the glass, and John Zeezer, the lone senior in their starting lineup. His first field goal, he has four. Lead is at 15 for Mater Dei. Nearly 4 minutes to play, quarter number four. Mater Dei trying to win a state title. They've done so in wrestling. They've been here in football, now trying to add to that in basketball. Good hustle by Halbig.
4 minutes to go. Take care of the basketball if you're Mater Dei. Get that kind of shot right there.
And a nice give and go on the bounce from Maier to Halbig. And the lead is 17 for Mater Dei. Ryan Schmidt, Minsterman defense, ball stolen, good read by Halbig. Bounces right into the hands of Minsterman, and now Mater Dei can take some time off the clock with 3.5 to play.
A defensive play as you see a jump ball.
Boy,
what I'm starting to say down at the other end, that you said a good read by Halbig, that's the kind of rotation they've had all evening.
Well, we're going to have a timeout. It will be the ball in possession of Mater Dei. When we come back, it's all Wildcats.
Dan Archer is the head coach at Bishop Chatard. And, Coach, it's been a year now since you won the state championship here in 3A, but you're seeing a very good Evansville Mater Dei team here tonight, aren't you?
Yeah, they're a solid ball club, and they don't have to convince me. They beat us last week, and that's what I told our team. We didn't lose. A good team beat us.
And they just seem to get better and better each week, just as you did last year.
Well, that's what championship teams do, and I've watched them this whole postseason, and this is probably their best game right here.
All right, Coach, thank you, and enjoy your week next week in vacation land.
We'll do it. Thank you.
All right. Back to you guys.
All right, thanks so much. Dan Archer leading that Bishop Chittard team to a state championship a year ago. He was a longtime assistant for Doug Mitchell at North Central High School and won that 3A state title game last year.
That foul was on Andy Reddington, his fourth for Evansville Mater Dei. I got some advice for all the coaches out there. If you want to get to the state finals, get it, change your mascot to an Indian. We had the Walden Mohawks here, the Brownstown Braves, and the Bellmont Braves. Or Wildcats is a good second choice, as we got Lawrence North and Mater Dei Wildcats. So there's the solution.
Yeah, you know, this has been a state tournament game for brothers and the same nicknames.
Right.
There's a highlight. Free throws now for Brian Schultz. 75% free throw shooter. His father, a 1977 heavyweight wrestling champion at Belmont. And again, these two schools, very well known in this state for wrestling. Belmont and Mater Dei, not so well known for basketball.
That shows that the son is pretty intelligent. Came to basketball, got off that mat where you have to roll around.
Greg Maier gives the ball to Zirkelbach.
In case you don't know, I'm a high school boys basketball fan. I make no secret about that.
Nice back pass. Reddington can't handle it. Gets it back to Halbig in the lane. We have a foul. And again, this venue, Conseco Fieldhouse, is a great site for the state wrestling championship. But as you said, Dave, and a lot of admiration for all the wrestling across the state. But when I was in physical education class and they wanted me to wrestle, that just wasn't really in the cards for me.
You didn't have wrestling, but I had a couple of classmates who wrestled. I'm telling you what, 2 minutes of that and you're dead.
They're too tough for me.
You're tired. You have to wear those knee pads and elbow pads and everything. I'd rather run around the floor. You know what? There's still 2 minutes and 19 seconds, but got to be a great feeling for John Gable sitting over there, sitting on this big lead, state championship game, only 2 minutes and 18 seconds left. And I'm sure that Sean Busick is thinking, you know, I want these kids to feel great about themselves. They probably got beat by a better basketball team tonight, but we're going to end up 22-5 and runner up and take a tremendous trophy back to Belmont. So he's got to feel really good and proud of his ball club as well.
Well, we have seen in these games, especially in the Class A game and this 3A game, as Wacey Hall misses the free throw. It was really a bad second quarter for Belmont. They were outscored 19-6, and you really throw in the final, 25 seconds of the first quarter, they were outscored 24-6, and that basically was the game, and Belmont's just never had the ability to get back in.
And there again, you saw Halbert just step in, anticipate the pass. How many times have you seen that? Mater Dei have played excellent defensively.
Evansville, Mater Dei, they play a good schedule down in the city of Evansville. Minsterman looks on the baseline. Reddington tried to deliver the ball, knocked out of bounds, and Mater Dei will inbound the basketball with 1:44 to play. That young man, Adam Arnold, a tremendous game. 21 points for Belmont, but he's not had a whole lot of help. It's been a difficult night for Belmont. There's the ball tipped into the hands of Ritchie, and he dunks it.
First basket of the game, I believe. Is that correct?
Yes, Aaron Ritchie. After missing his first four shots, gets the breakaway dunk. Then a hustling play there by Schultz. This Belmont team has not quit tonight. There you see the Evansville Mater Dei crowd. There's head coach Sean Buse of the Belmont.
Here's a look at that dunk, and you're going to see Aaron Ritchie just out in front, Tommyhawks down. That's a 6'7 young man that can play the perimeter. You're going to hear about him next year. Not a bad player to start next year with. And, of course, you've got a Schmidt back next year. You've got Arnold back next year. And you've got Schultz back next year.
Well, again, this was a team that many thought was a year away, and this would be a good experience for them to be in the state championship game as juniors and work all summer long to try to get back here next year. Free throw is good by Wacey Hall. Wacey Hall with 16 points. Maier has 10, now make it 17 for the 6'9 junior.
He gets my trophy for his first name. You like Wacey? I love that name. I don't think I've ever announced a game for sure. I've heard a basketball player named Wacey, but I like it.
Jason Miller hit the three for the Bellmont Braves. It's a 15-point Mater Dei lead and a personal foul. Minsterman will go to the free throw line for a 1-1 opportunity now for Mater Dei. Again, they were here in 2001. They were in the semi-state in both 2000 and 2001. They won the semi-state to get to Conseco Fieldhouse when they lost to Muncie South 81-78. And it sure does appear that they will get the 3A state championship here tonight. Minsterman, the free throw is good. .116 to play. First 2 points of the fourth quarter for Kelly Minsterman. Miller down the floor. Ball knocked out of bounds and a foul. Minsterman commits it. And Jason Miller to the free throw line for the Bellmont Braves. They were perfect at home this year, 10-0. 6-4 on the road, 22-4 coming in, ranked 7th in the state. This is a modern day ball club that was unranked. They were not ranked in the top 10 in Class 3A.
They're fulfilling a dream of every high school player that is playing or ever has played in the state of Indiana. They're going to win a state championship tonight, and the same could be said for Bellmont. These kids are going to remember this final championship game. It'll take a day or two for them to feel real good about it, but they're going to look back with tremendous pride and great feeling.
Sean Busick is clearing the bench now. Adam Arnold has left with 21 points. You see Brian Schultz leaving. We'll get some of the young men's names on. Bellmont out of northeastern Indiana, just southeast of Fort Wayne. On the floor is Corey Edding, a 5'10 junior for the Braves, as is Craig Miller, a 6-foot sophomore. And the free throw by Jason Miller. He has 4 points all here in the quarter. 15-point lead. Craig Maier ahead to Halbig. They get it across the line. Halbig has the ball. Pressured there. Gets to the hoop and draws the foul. Inside a minute. There you see it. 59-210 seconds to play.
Nice replay as Halbig goes to the basket. And you see Craig Miller just was not quite able to get over an established position. Blocking foul.
And Halbig now in double figures. He has 10. So 17 for Hall, 10 for Maier, and 10 for Halbig. But they've had great balance. They have Reddington with 8. They have Minsterman with 8. And Alcorn has 6. Final 55 seconds. Matt Neidlinger on the floor now for Bellmont. Shot is missed from three-point range by Miller. Basketball stays with Bellmont. Second-year head coach John Gable will win a state championship with Mater Dei. Three-point shot short by John Baker. Wacey Hall to the basket. Missed it. Rebound Halbig. And he looks and draws the foul. Sean Busick wasn't very happy about that call. He thought Wacey Hall had charged, and I might have agreed with him.
I don't disagree with him. And, of course, part of that is just the frustration. He knows his ball club shoots so much better than they did tonight. And I can tell you as a coach, the emotions build up. And you don't fault any coach for that.
Halbig is now 6 of 7 at the free throw line as a team. Mater Dei 15 of 20 at 75%. They've shot 53% from the field and 46% behind the arc. And they have pretty much for three quarters of the game dominated it here. And Halbig gets the rebound, outlets the ball now to Lee Schoolfield. And Schoolfield is fouled and gives him the opportunity to go to the free throw line. He gets a big bear hug there by Matt Halbig. Schoolfield is a senior. Halbig is a senior. They only have 3 seniors on the roster. These juniors have another shot here, but this is it for the seniors, and they'll go out with a state championship.
Hey, a lot of pressure on Lee Schoolfield. He's a senior, chance to get his name in the record book.
That's right.
On the state championship game when they won the state.
And he got it.
Big basket for that young man.
Danny Martin comes in as Matt Halbig, the senior, will leave. A big hug from Craig Maier. And we'll also see two more Mater Dei Wildcats get in. Schoolfield again. Hits them both. Coming in, Kyle Grossman as Wacey Hall will leave. Craig Maier leaves. And Brandon Deeg is in. 20-point lead for the Wildcats of Evansville Mater Dei. They will win the 2004 3A state championship. Nice drive and a shot by Jason Miller. He has a chance for a three-point play. Miller has 6 points here in the fourth quarter.
In fact, in the last 2.5 minutes, Jason Miller's come in and scored 6. Chance to go for 7. He's a senior also. Left-handed dribble, hard take to the basket. Determination gets him a chance for 3.
Free throw no good. Kyle Grossman the rebound for the final 22 seconds. Schoolfield has the ball. Bellmont double teaming. The Wildcats do not have to shoot with 13 seconds to play. Schoolfield out to Zirkelbach. 8 seconds to play. 7 seconds. Mater Dei will win the Class 3A state championship game at Conseco Fieldhouse. The Evansville Mater Dei Wildcats, the state champions here in 2004. Tell you, Dave Nicholson, I look behind me, it goes all the way to the top of the building with Evansville Mater Dei fans. They build it from the youth, and they have watched the youth have become young men. They have won a state championship.
Well, Chris, you know, every team here today has had tremendous followings from their communities, and that's a great thing to see them come out and support their high school basketball team. That's the way it should be, and kids, that's why they want to play basketball. They love the game, but also they know,
Jerry, he didn't know who
people
you
get behind them, get excited, and that makes it double fun to be a player and to be a part of a team. Every team here today is showing that kind of support. Belmont's equally supportive of their team, and they're going to support them even though they were running out.
Evansville Mater Dei is the Class 3A state champions, an 18-point win over Belmont here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Evansville Mater Dei has won the 3A state championship here at Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. The Wildcats by 18, 63-45. Kristen Airy and Dave Nicholson will hear from Craig Wallen here coming up. Here's our Reeves Buick Pontiac play of the game.
Nice spin move by Craig Halbig. Comes back to the left hand, spins it up and under. 2 of his 12 points for the ball game.
Halbig had 12 points. Wacey Hall had 17, and Craig Maier had 10. Adam Arnold had a game-high 21 points to lead Belmont. But Evansville Mater Dei is the state champion. They win by 18 points. And standing by was second-year head coach John Gable. He is a state champion. Here's Craig. Craig?
All right, guys. Thank you very much, Coach Gable. Congratulations. Got to feel pretty good. You've played ugly. You've played good. And this happened to be one of those nights that you played really well. Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm really proud of our kids and all the work that they put in throughout the year. And this is just the icing on the cake for all of it. Really happy for the team.
You know, I think one of the highest compliments paid to your team tonight was when we were talking to others about the style of your game and the way that the team continued to get better every step of the way, really from postseason all the way till tonight.
Yeah, we had a few chances this year where things didn't go our way, and they could have put their heads down, and they didn't. They kept working. And, you know, they got better at end-of-game situations and shooting and foul shots. And, you know, they worked and worked, and they earned this.
You've had 3 really great performances here tonight, 3 players in double figures. But it's all about we and not about those 3 necessarily, is it?
Right. We played 10 guys tonight, and whether they were on for 30 seconds or 10 minutes, they contributed. Everyone contributed, and that's been a big help for us, that we don't have anyone that's selfish or anyone that thinks of themselves first.
All right, Coach, again, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Head Coach John Gable. Back to you guys.
All right, thanks so much, Craig. He is a six-year assistant, now a second-year head coach, and John Gable leads Evansville Mater Dei to a state championship. There you see the 3A Trestle Award winner, and from Belmont, John Zeezer. Evansville Mater Dei beats Belmont by 18, 63-45. They're the 3A state champions. Evansville Mater Dei, the Wildcats, the 3A state champions here in boys basketball here in the Hoosier State. And it was really keyed at the end of the first quarter with Belmont leading 10-9. Kelly Minsterman hit a three, Drew Alcorn a steal, and scored at the buzzer to give them the lead. That keyed a 22-4 run covering the end of the first quarter and most of the second, and an 18-point win for Evansville Mater Dei. Let's go back courtside. Here's Craig Wallen. Craig?
All right, thank you very much. Here are the winners. Wacey Hall, congratulations. Big game for you tonight. 17 points. And how does it feel?
It feels great. It's been a lifelong dream of mine to get this far, and we finally did it. I love it.
Well, you played great inside, and you had some great perimeter help from this guy right here, Craig Maier. Congratulations. And it has to feel pretty good for you, knowing as well that you're coming back next year.
Yeah, it's a great feeling. Like Wacey says, it's the best feeling in the world. Can't get any better.
What about this guy next to you, Matt Halbig?
He's an unbelievable player. He's carried us on his shoulders the entire year.
Matt, congratulations. One of the lone seniors on this team. Does it feel kind of bittersweet here, knowing that you won't be around next year?
Yeah, I mean, this is the greatest accomplishment that I could ever dream of, but knowing that this is the last game I'm ever going to play, and with the victory at Conseco Fieldhouse, it's the greatest way to go out.
All right, Matt. Well, you did great. Congratulations, and go celebrate.
Thank you.
All right. Here with the Wildcats. Back to you guys.
All right, Craig, thanks so much. Always great to hear from the players. That's where it's decided on the floor, the young men. And Evansville Mater Dei really came out and played very well. And again, that big run, and really the end of the first quarter, the big three by Minsterman, the steal by Alcorn, really changed the momentum of the game.
Well, if you boil the whole thing down, Chris, it just comes down to the inability of Belmont to make shots tonight. They had plenty of attempts, and I know they're a better shooting ball club than what they showed. And, of course, Sean Busick, the coach, knows that. The players know that. But it was one of those nights that every player have, and it happened that no one could really get their offense going outside of Adam Arnold to any degree. So they will feel good about the year. They feel terrible about this last game, but there's only four teams going to feel good about the last game.
There you see on the left, that's John Zeezer. He won the Trestler Award. We'll hope to hear from him. In the middle, Adam Arnold. To his right, Aaron Ritchie. And Belmont is the runner-up, and they'll be back hopefully for another crack at it next year. 63-45, Evansville Mater Dei wins the 3A state championship. There you see the final. If you're just tuning in, Evansville Mater Dei wins the 3A state title game by 18, 63-45. They led at the end of one, 14-10, led by 17 at the half, 33-16. Had a 19-point lead after three at 47-28. Belmont outscored the Wildcats in the fourth quarter, 17-16, and an 18-point win for Mater Dei. Again, they had three players in double figures, but very good balance for Mater Dei. They shot 53% from the field, 46% from behind the arc, and 74% at the free throw line. The numbers not so good for Belmont, as Dave said. 36% from the field, 23% from three-point range, and 67% at the free throw line. The big cheer you hear there, you see the medals, the hardware dangling. John Gable, in his second year, wins a state title. His uncle Mike is the football and wrestling coach. John Gable was a six-year assistant. They kept it in the family, and the family delivers at Mater Dei.
Well, we had a rookie coach win this afternoon from Waldron, a second-year coach tonight. And for any coach, it's a highlight of your career to win the state tournament. But doing it that early in your career has got to be a special feeling. Only thing you can do is maintain. You cannot get better than that.
And there you see the presentation of the state championship hardware And a big smile from Matt Halbig there, the senior. And there you see the big crowd from Evansville that made their way to Conseco Fieldhouse on this Saturday night. Evansville Mater Dei had been here before. Three seasons ago, they fell 3 points shy to Muncie South. They did not fall shy tonight.
Well, I'm sure having been here, they drew a little bit, even though it's not the same player. You draw from that tradition. If a school has tradition, kids that follow think, they did it, we can do it. It's not new territory, whereas Bellmont now kind of laid that groundwork this year, and I'm sure after a few hours or a few days, they're going to start talking about next year. We want to get back to the state. We know how to go there now and how to win things.
All right, let's head back courtside. Craig Walden is standing by with Bellmont head coach Sean Busick and our Mental Attitude Award winner, John Zeezer.
All right, Chris, thank you very much, Coach. Yeah, I know you're not all that satisfied right now, although it was a tremendous run for you. Classic overachievers, you did a lot.
Well, we're really proud of our kids. Unfortunately, you know, I look at the shooting percentages tonight. They shoot over 50, and we shoot under 40. And usually the team that gets the ball inside and hits their shots wins every game, and they did today. So credit goes to Mater Dei, but I'm still very proud of my kids for what they accomplished this year. It was a great run, and hopefully we can make a run next year as well.
Talk a little bit about the Trester Award winner here tonight, John Zeezer.
Well, John Zeezer has been the heart and soul of our basketball team for the past 2 years. And, you know, I don't know if there's ever been as good a recipient as John Zeezer. The committee sure did a great job of choosing him. He's a great young man. This is his second state finals appearance. He played in the state baseball finals 2 years ago in baseball as a sophomore starting left fielder. He's just a great kid. He's done so much for Bellmont Athletics, and we're really going to miss his leadership on our basketball team.
That senior leadership, very, very important. Won't be around next year, but I trust his legacy will continue into next season.
Well, I hope so, and he's just a great young man, a great family, and well-deserved.
All right, Coach, we'll let you get back to your team. Congratulations on a great year.
Thank you very much.
Sean Busick, and we'll work over here to the Trester Award winner if we can get to him in just a moment. And interesting sidebar, guys. John Zeezer, the Trester Award winner from Bellmont, played over the summer with the Trester Award winner from the 2A game, Kyle Johnson. They were on the same team together in Northwest Indiana. So two outstanding basketball players. And, you know, they had no idea in the summer that they'd be back here, each of them playing in their own championship game. And then on top of that, each winning a Trester Award. Well, John Zeezer is available now. John, congratulations on the Trester. How does it make you feel?
It's a great honor to receive this award. I just wish we would have won the game, but that would have been great. But losing this game is just the worst feeling ever. It's like my heart was ripped out and just stepped on because I love basketball, and I know that I'll never put on this uniform again. But receiving the award is just a great honor for me. So,
well, John, you know, you touched a lot of lives during your career at Bellmont, and just think of those that you've touched that will continue playing next season. That has to make you feel good.
Yeah, I just like to give all my credit to the juniors that and the coaching staff and the sophomores, all the people that I've touched or whatever, but they're going to do it next year. I just have total confidence in them, and all the little kids that I've helped to work on their skills and their hard work, hopefully it pays off, and it will. So,
well, you know, you hang with winners. Kyle Johnson, the other Trester Award winner, your buddy from this past summer.
Yeah, Kyle's a great man. He's awesome, and I'm glad they won it. They actually got the job done. We couldn't get the job done, but it's just great to have Kyle win the Trester. He's a great man. So,
all right. Congratulations again.
Thank you. Thank you.
Chris, Dave, back to you.
All right. Thanks, Craig. 63-45, Evansville Mater Dei, the 3A state champion. They join Waldron and Jimtown as titleists today. There you see the happy Wildcats here in Indianapolis.